Hi all, I'm Kemiko, your chemistry teacher. Welcome to Tiger and Cat channel. Don't forget to subscribe, like, and share. Today we are going to discuss about van der Waals forces.
Intermolecular forces. Can we check for this diagram, right? Okay, this is hydrogen chloride molecule. This is another hydrogen chloride molecule. Okay, the forces between the hydrogen atom and the chlorine atom we call it as intramolecular forces. Dalaman, intramolecular. Okay, the forces between the hydrogen chloride molecule with another hydrogen chloride molecule we call it as intermolecular forces or intermolecular attraction. Okay, this intermolecular attraction is a weak forces. And then this intramolecular forces is covalent bond, is a strong bond. Okay, yeah? So as I said just now, there are two types of intermolecular forces, which is hydrogen bond and van der Waals forces. And then van der Waals forces, there are two types, dipole-dipole forces and London dispersion forces. If we compare, right, among these three, hydrogen bond is the strongest one, followed by dipole-dipole forces or dipole-dipole interaction, and then the weakest one is the London dispersion forces. Here, can get it? Hydrogen bond, van der Waals forces. Van der Waals forces, there are two dipole-dipole forces. Okay, jot down. This one special for polar molecule. And then London dispersion forces is for non-polar molecule. Okay, so now we check. What is dipole-dipole forces? If you check your tutorial, right, question number 1A, what are dipole-dipole forces? B, how do polar molecules attract each other? So we are going to find the answer now. Okay, so dipole-dipole forces is the forces arise from the attraction of the permanent positive and negative end of a neutral polar molecule. If you look at this one, this hydrogen chloride molecule, hydrogen always partially positive, and then chloride and ion always partially negative. That's why we are using the term permanently positive and negative end. Okay, due to the partially positive, partially negative, if they join together, it become a neutral polar molecule. Why is polar? Still remember, during 4.2, we learned about dipole moment. So this one partially positive, this one partially negative, it will form a dipole moment from partially positive point to partially negative. Since this one cannot cancel off each other, the dipole moment cannot cancel off each other. So this is polar molecule. Okay. Okay. For dipole-dipole forces, right? If the molecule more polar, it will have a large dipole moment and stronger dipole-dipole forces. So needs more energy to overcome the strong dipole-dipole forces. Does its boiling point increase? So in conclusion, we can say, okay, more polar the molecule, stronger the dipole-dipole forces, then higher the boiling point. Okay, so can you answer question number 1A? What are dipole-dipole forces? So this is the answer. Okay. The forces arise from the attraction of the permanently positive and negative end of a neutral polar molecule. Okay, please jot down. And then question number B, how do polar molecules attract each other? Okay. Macam mana dia boleh attract each other? Okay, everybody please jot down. The answer over this slide as well. Okay. The polar molecule attract each other. How? Okay, this is one of the polar molecule. This one is another one polar molecule. So how both molecule attract each other? So you need to explain. Polar molecule attract each other. You look at here. You must make sure that when the partially positive charge on one molecule is near to the partially negative charge on the other molecule. Okay, the first point you must mention, the partial positive charge on one molecule is near, make sure it's near to the partially negative charge on the other molecule. Okay, so point number two, the polar molecule must be close together. Okay, the polar molecule must be close together for the dipole-dipole forces to be significant. The polar molecule must be close together for the dipole-dipole forces to be significant. Maksudnya, kalau dia tak dekat, okay, dipole-dipole forces ni tak akan wujud. Okay, and then point number three, dipole-dipole forces increase with an increase of the polarity of the molecule. Ataupun you terus guna inilah. A more polar molecule have large dipole moment has a stronger dipole-dipole forces. Pun boleh. Get it? So this is the answer for question 1B. How do polar molecule attract each other? Dapat ikut? Taufik?
Madam,
cakap.
Yes, Madam.
Madam, ulang.
Oh, ulang.
Ulang, Madam. Yang... Tak rapat.
You tengok gambar raja. Ras, jangan jangan dengar je. You tengok penerangan saya berdasarkan gambar raja. Okay? Sekejap. Okay, this card. Okay, 1A no problem, right? 1A? 1A jawapan ni terus. 1A terus jawapan ni. Okay, terus jawapan ni. Okay, so this is the answer for 1A. Straight away you can take all the answers. So this is for 1A. Okay, 1B. Okay. Jangan buat apa semua. Dengar slide je. Dengar apa yang saya cakap. Dengar apa saya yang lukis kat sini sekarang. I guna color. Okay. I guna ink yellow lah. Dengar. Soalan dia tanya. How do polar molecule attract each other? So you kena jawab lengkap. Polar molecule attract each other when the partial positive charge on one molecule is near the partially negative charge on the other molecule. Dapat? Faham? Ayat pertama. The partial positive on one molecule, molecule ni lah, one molecule, is near the partial negative on the other molecule. Okay. Point number two, the polar molecule must be close. Must be close for the dipole-dipole forces to be significant. Tadi saya dah cakap, dia mesti dekat. Kalau tak dekat, tak ada dipole-dipole forces. The polar molecules must be enclosed together for the dipole-dipole forces to be significant. Okay, so point number three, terus ambil ayat ni pun tak ada masalah. Nak beritahu ialah, dipole-dipole forces increase with an increase in polarity of the molecule. Okay, tadi kita cakap macam mana dia nak bentukkan dipole-dipole forces. Kemudian jarak dipole-dipole forces mesti dekat. Jadi kekuatan dipole-dipole forces bergantung apa? Bergantung kepada kepolaran dia. Semakin polar, semakin besar dipole moment, semakin kuat ikatan dipole-dipole forces. Okay? Boleh?
Boleh.
Okay. So now we look at one sample question, one example. So you look propane, acetaldehyde. Okay. Every time when you answer this kind of question, right, I say before, must have similarity and difference. Setiap kali you jawab soalan untuk penerangan, you mesti cari persamaan dan perbezaan. So in this case, the similarity is molar mass. Same relative molecular mass. What's the difference? Okay, the difference is this one, dipole moment. This one, larger dipole moment. Higher boiling point. Why?
Penerangan nombor tiga tadi.
Penerangan apa?
Penerangan nombor tiga tadi.
Ni? 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 Ni penerangan ketiga? Tadi saya cakap.
Kalau Madam, yeah? Sorry to disturb. Use dia terkeluar sebab internet lambat.
Okay.
Okay. Jawapan dia penerangan nombor tiga, penerangan nombor empat.
Tak ada empat lah, satu, dua, tiga je.
Feeling increase.
Taufik, point number one ialah apa?
Point number one. The partially positive of one molecule must near to the partially negative to the other molecule.
Betul. Point number two.
The polar molecule must close together for dipole forces to be significant.
Betul. Point ketiga.
A more polar molecule has large dipole moment, has a stronger dipole forces.
Yeah. Okay, so dipole-dipole forces bertambah berdasarkan polariti dia. Semakin polar, semakin besar dipole moment, semakin kuat ikatan dipole-dipole forces. Okay, good. Okay, so kita sambung. Untuk case ini, dia bagi dua. Propene acetaldehyde. Okay, madam dah cakap setiap kali you terang, you kena beritahu. Okay, persamaan dan perbezaan. Ni persamaan dia. Same relative molecular mass. Okay, perbezaan. Satu dipole moment 0.1, satu dipole moment 2.7. Mengapa ini lebih besar? Kerana dia polar molecule. Stronger dipole-dipole forces compared to propane. Jadi, boiling point dia lebih tinggi. Itu je. Okay. Ini lebih polar. Okay.
Okay.
Now kita pergi London dispersion forces.
London.
Yeah, kita pergi London sekejap. Okay, ya, pergi UK, London. Okay. Weak temporary forces. Tadi tu macam mana? Tadi tu permanent positive and negative and for dipole-dipole forces. But this one is weak temporary forces. And non-polar molecule. Tadi tu apa? Tadi tu apa yang ni? Yang ini ialah neutral polar molecule. Dipole-dipole ialah permanent positive, negative, lepas tu polar molecule. Yang ini songsang dia ialah temporary forces, non-polar molecule. Tapi kena alert, dia wujud kat semua atom dan molecule. Dia wujud kat semua atom dan molekul. Okay, how the London dispersion forces arise because electron in atom or molecule constant motion. Asyik bergerak. Electron dalam molekul ataupun atom dia bergerak. Jadi hasillah London dispersion forces. Tapi apa yang dia hasilkan ialah sementara sahaja. Dia akan berubah berdasarkan pergerakan elektron. Okay. Inilah secara surface untuk menerangkan London dispersion forces. Mari kita tengok detail dia. Okay. An atom has proton in its nucleus and electron surrounding the nucleus. This is what we know. Okay, electron will move around the nucleus, okay, of an atom. On average, the negative charge of the atom is spread evenly around the nucleus. So we look at this one. This is an atom. Okay, there is a atom, there is a nucleus, and then electron move around. When the electron move around, it's distributed equally. Paham? Gambaran ni? This is a nucleus, this is the atom, and then all the electron move around the nucleus of an atom, and then the distribution of the electron is equally. Okay. Aisha. Aisha?
Yes.
Sini Pak Chah siapa? Kat sini positive. Nak. Hah?
Negative.
Okay. Sini Chah siapa?
Negative.
Jadi negatif akan macam mana?
Dia akan tolak. Dia akan
Yes, keywords tolak. Okay. Well, thank you Aisha. Negative charge will push apart. Jadi sini menolak ke sini. Ini pun menolak ke sini. Jadi elektron semua akan kat bahagian sinilah. So that's why terhasillah gambar rajah yang seterusnya. So at in any instant, one side of the molecule has higher electron density than the other side. So here partially negative, higher electron density. Here partially positive, lower electron density. So the atom or the molecule become a small instantaneous dipole. Yep, menjadi satu kutub lah yang sementara. Karena elektron dia bergerak, dia boleh ubah tempat. Tapi pergerakan tadi ini, dia push apart menghasilkan inilah. Ini panggil instantaneous temporary dipole. Okay, jadi yang partially positive ini, dia akan bertemu satu molekul yang partially negative. Jadi partially positive, partially negative. Okay, Ramiza akan macam mana kalau partially positive, partially negative?
Dia tertarik.
Yes, tertarik. Maka hasillah London dispersion forces ni. Okay, so the temporary dipole can induce a similar dipole on a neighboring atom and can be attracted to one another. So this interaction is called London dispersion forces and only significant, again significant, when atom are close together. Tadi dipole-dipole pun sama. Dia mesti kena dekat. London dispersion forces pun sama, kena tekat juga, baru akan hasil. Okay, so slide from here, this one, two, yeah. Okay, ulang. This slide one, slide two, slide three is the answer for 1C. Explain how London forces or how London dispersion forces arise between non-polar molecules. So question number 3A, give the factors that influence the strength of the van der Waals forces. So these are the answer, molecular size, molecular shape, and molecular polarity. Antara ketiga-tiga ini, ada satu faktor memberi dominan. Tak kisah macam mana, kita akan tengok dia dulu. Jawapan yang mana, you akan tahu dah. Okay, Nana, jawapan yang mana? You tengok. Tengok sini pun tahu jawapan dah. Antara tiga-tiga ini, mana paling dominan?
Molecular size.
Yeah, you nampak tak? Bulatan yang paling besar. Okay. Molecular size is the dominant factor that influence the van der Waals forces. Okay. Mari kita tengok satu demi satu lah. So first of all, molecular size increase, number of electron increase. So valence electron are further from the nucleus and can be distorted easily. So the polarizability ini maksudnya kepolaran dia. Okay, increase meningkat. So higher the polarizability, stronger the van der Waals forces. Okay, so maksudnya kita tengok size dulu. Semakin besar size tu, semakin banyak elektron. Jadi semakin banyak elektron, okay, elektron dia boleh menghasilkan satu elektron cloud yang kita cakap tadi, dia boleh menghasilkan kepolaran. Kepolaran yang tinggi tu menyebabkan van der Waals forces dia semakin kuat. Okay, lepas tu kita tengok ini. Antara semua ni dia paling tinggi sekali. Semakin negatif semakin kecil ah, semakin ni kurang negatif, maksudnya boiling point dia paling tinggi. Mengapa? Kerana size. This is group 18. Ini kumpulan 18. Going down group 18. Jadi going down the group memang size radium dia meningkat. Ini paling besar sekali. Kalau besar macam mana? Bilangan elektron tambah. More distance over which electron can move increase. stronger dispersion forces. Means stronger van der Waals forces. Okay, kalau shape kita tengok. Kita tengok gambar raja ni dulu. Butane macam ni, kita panggil dia linear. Okay, 2-methylpropane ada cabangan. So, ada cabangan kita panggil dia branch. So, long and linear molecule can develop bigger temporary dipole due to larger surface area. Keywords dia larger surface area. Kalau surface area dia besar, temporary dipole pun besar. Compare dengan electron, which electron get moved, okay? Compare dengan short and branch one containing the same number of electron. Maksudnya kalau linear banding dengan branch, linear temporary dipole dia lebih besar kerana surface area dia besar. Elektron boleh bergerak. Pada masa yang sama, long and linear molecule can also lie closer together. Dia boleh antara satu sama lain lebih dekat lah. Jadi, stronger London forces, greater Van der Waals forces. Okay, faktor ketiga. Okay, ni contoh soalan tadi lah. Contoh soalan ini, dia membuat penerangan. Okay, madam ulang sekali lagi. Setiap kali untuk menerangkan soalan explain, you kena bandingkan persamaan dan perbezaan. Okay, so for this case, the similarity is both of them have the same molecular mass. Sama je. 22 pun 4 carbon. Tapi, butane has higher boiling point. Because linear. You must mention linear. If linear, larger surface area. If larger surface area of contact, what happened? Stronger the dispersion forces. Okay, you cakap pasal butane. You pun kena cakap pasal methylpropane. Okay. For this one, you must mention, this one is branch alkene. So, it's spherical shape, more compact. Smaller surface area of contact. Jadi, weaker dispersion forces. Yeah. Okay, the last factors is about molecular polarity. So, for molecular polarity senang. Satu polar, satu non-polar. Jadi, polar kita belajar tadi ialah dipole-dipole interaction. Kalau non-polar ialah non-polar ialah pergi London, London dispersion forces. Jadi apa yang kita sedia maklumkan, dipole-dipole forces lebih kuat daripada London dispersion forces. Okay, semua sila keluarkan highlighter atau pen apa ke, you kena kotakkan, lukiskan, macam mana kena ingat. Kalau you nak guna penerangan ini, you mesti banding secara similar molar mass. Kalau tak similar molar mass, kita tak payah tengok faktor ni. Kerana tak similar molar mass, kita akan tengok faktor molecular size. Yeah. Jadi kalau you nak bandingkan molecular polarity, dua-dua molekul tu mesti mempunyai similar molar mass. And then dipole-dipole forces is for polar. London dispersion forces is for non-polar. So by using this example. Okay. If you calculate the molar mass of both compound, they are having identical number of electrons because similar molecular mass. Kalau tak percaya, cuba tekan. 16 campur 3, campur 16, campur 3. Sorry, 14. 14 campur 3, 14 campur 3. 28, 34. Ni 34. Kalau fluorine ialah berapa? Fluorine 19. 19 campur 14 campur 3. Sama dengan berapa? Tiga puluh enam. Okay, ada orang tak faham I tahu. Okay, yang ini YouTuber. Okay, 12 campur 3 campur 12 campur 3 sama dengan 30. Okay, dan ini okay, 19 campur 12 campur 3 sama dengan 34. Jadi lebih kurang sama lah. Okay, so based on here right, dia lebih kurang sama. Okay, walaupun beza sikit, kita consider dia lebih kurang sama. Kerana dia tak jauh banyak berbeza. Okay, so that's why both molecule having the identical number of electron almost similar. Jadi kita guna perkataan almost similar molecular mass. Okay, tapi untuk 18, dia non-polar. Untuk forum 18, dia polar. Yang non-polar ni ialah London dispersion forces. Yang polar ini ialah dipole-dipole interaction. So you kena beritahu forum 18 higher boiling point because it is polar, strong dipole-dipole forces. Yang 18 non-polar, it has weak London dispersion forces. Untuk slide ini hilang satu point, sila tambah. You kena cakap pasal ni. You kena tambah ayat ni. Semua orang pay attention please. You kena tambah ayat ni. Kena tambah ini. So kena beritahu dipole-dipole forces is stronger than London dispersion forces. Ikut. Hello, semua orang ikut?
Ikut, ikut.
Okay, tambah ayat ni ya. Kena tambah ayat ni.
Dah, dah.
Okay ya. Semasa terang-terang-terang, you kena beritahu. Ni lebih tinggi kerana dia polar. Mengapa polar ni lebih tinggi? Kerana ikatan dia ialah dipole-dipole forces. Dipole-dipole forces lebih kuat daripada London dispersion forces. That's why boiling point dia lebih tinggi. Okay, tengok. Next. Untuk case ini, ni polar, ni non-polar. Tapi yang non-polar boiling point dia lebih tinggi. Mengapa? Alia, mengapa? Alia, mengapa?
Sebab termina sama.
Oh, no, 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 no. Okay. Kalau berdasarkan tadi sini kan, Alia?
Ah?
Okay, kita cakap. Oh, ini polar, ini non-polar. Oh, yang polar tu lebih tinggi melting point kerana dia ialah dipole-dipole forces. Tapi untuk case ini, you tengok. Ini non-polar.
Polar.
76. Ini polar 61. Mengapa? Bukan sepatutnya polar lebih tinggi ke? Tapi mengapa polar sekarang lebih rendah? Ha, mengapa?
Dipole-dipole.
Dua-dua pun dipole. Oh, ini dipole-dipole. Ini London dispersion. Jadi, betul lah. Yang sepatutnya mana kuat? London-London ke dipole-dipole?
London-London. Dipole-dipole.
Okay. Dipole-dipole lebih kuat kan? Tapi, you tengok. Ni, dipole-dipole. Kuat, tapi dia rendah. Dia tak tinggi. Mengapa? Ada sesiapa tahu mengapa?
Size.
Yeah, size. Size. Betul. Oh. Size. Chlorine lebih besar daripada hidrogen. Kerana tadi I cakap apa? Kalau you nak bandingkan polariti, you mesti banding secara similar molar mass. Untuk case ini, dia tak similar molar mass. Mass untuk chlorine ni lebih besar. Tadi I dah cakap dari awal. Ha, I tanya. antara tiga faktor ini, yang mana ialah faktor utama? Size. Okay. Size. Size akan mempengaruhi semua. Tak kira dia pola ke tak pola, size diberi keutamaan. So that's why for this case, CHCl3 is a polar molecule. Dipole-dipole. CCl4 non-polar, London dispersion. Tapi CCl4 lebih tinggi kerana, okay, bigger molecular. Size with more electron, larger molar mass. So for this case, the increase in the dispersion forces between CCl4 molecule dominate the dipole-dipole interaction between CH3, Cl3. Okay, faham? Okay. Okay, good. Sekarang mari tengok soalan 3B1 dan 3B2. Okay, which molecule has a higher boiling point? Explain. Br2 dengan ICl. You check size dia dulu. Pergi ambil list constant, tengok relative atomic mass. Semua orang semak sendiri, kena biasa. Tengok relative atomic mass borin, bromin, iodine, korin. Check size dia. Semua orang pergi rujuk. Semua wajib rujuk. Yang mana lebih tinggi boiling point?
ICl.
Okay, jawapan betul. Okay, so you kena pergi jawapan. ICl has higher boiling point. Full stop. Markah pertama. Okay. Markah kedua, terang. Macam mana nak terangkan? So penerangan dia sebiji dengan sini. I tak share lagi. Okay. Jawapan you all sila ambil ni. Sebiji. Hanya tukar nama je. Betul ke? Bukan ni. Ni. Okay, penerangan untuk 3B, bromin dengan ICl guna ni. Kerana dia memang satu pola, satu non-pola. Okay, tapi saiz mereka lebih kurang sama. Jadi elektron lebih kurang sama. Identical number of electron and almost similar to molecular mass. Okay, boleh ya? Satu poin, dua poin, tiga poin, empat poin ya? Okay.
Boleh.
Okay, yang kedua, iodine dengan bromin. Yang mana? Taufik, yang mana iodine dengan bromin?
Iodine.
Ya, yeah, betul. Mengapa?
Sebab dia saiz dia lagi besar.
Okay, selain saiz, apakah persamaan mereka? You mesti beritahu persamaan dulu.
Dia punya dua-dua non-polar.
Yes, dua-dua pun non-polar. Okay. Lepas tu you tengok. Okay, tengok screen saya. Dua-dua pun non-polar, betul. Lepas tu bromin lebih, iodine lebih besar daripada bromin. Jadi iodine is more polarizable or has higher polarizable. Why? Because it's larger molecular mass. Hence, stronger intermolecular forces. Semasa cakap dua-dua pun non-polar, you kena cakap pasal size, kena cakap pasal polarizability. Ya? Yeah? Catatkan lah. Jawapan dia macam ni. Okay. Size of bromine. Okay. Jawapan you all kata macam ni lah. So, dua-dua, both molecule are non-polar. Jawapan dia ialah iodine dulu. Iodine. Iodine has higher boiling point. Okay. Point number dua, both molecule are non-polar. Tapi, size iodine is bigger than chlorine. Oh, okay. So iodine is more polarizability and sama lah ni, hence stronger intermolecular forces. Okay, ya? Catatkan lah ni jawapan dia. Okay, ya? Yang bawah ni tak ada berkaitan lah. Ni tak ada berkaitan. Okay, so ni jawapan untuk 2B2, 3B2. Ataupun you all ambil penerangan sini pun boleh. dah catat ke belum? Okay, sorry ya madam, nak tambah lagi. Okay, ini jawapan dia. Ya. Semua catatkan.
Hope you all learn something. Thank you.